I'm with Denise Kiernan and Joe Dagnese, the authors of Signing Their Lives Away, the fame and misfortune of the men who signed the Declaration of Independence. And if we could tell people one thing they really ought to know about these 56 men, what would it be?
At least five of these men were imprisoned by the British during that war.
And a lot of them were just like you and me. People who found themselves, ordinary people who found themselves in an extraordinary moment in time and did their best to rise to the occasion.
John Hart of New Jersey, small farmer, signed the Declaration of Independence. He sort of disappears into history, never does that much. On the other end, you see guys who were tradesmen. A couple of men actually ran iron mills in Pennsylvania. So it's a large number of different professions.
But Denise, in the main, people of property, people of station, people of some renown, at least in their home state?
Some of them, yes. And I would say probably the majority of them. But even within the group of what we would consider to be the most well-known signers, you have someone like Benjamin Franklin, who started off life indentured to his brother, really without much money at all. And then you have someone like Thomas Jefferson, who came from the planter class and had a certain amount of privilege.
Famously, both John Adams and Thomas Jefferson lived to the 50th anniversary of the Declaration of Independence. Anybody else live a long and happy life where they were able to look back on
a
job well done?
They were both outlived.
By one man.
By one man named Charles Carroll of Carrollton. And he is the longest lived signer. So what's interesting about Adams and Jefferson is that they died within hours of each other. And I believe it was Adams on his bed that said,
Jefferson survives.
What he should have said is, Carroll's beaten us both out, because he was still going. I think he even helped drive in a stake for one of the first railroads.
Yeah, he lived to the age of the railroads and was riding horses into his 90s. So
he was the only Catholic signer.
Yeah.
There was only one Catholic signer, and he was the only Catholic signer.
Denise and Joe, thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.